In this video, I'd like to introduce you to a new brush pack called Snow for Painter Essentials. This pack includes 10 brushes to build or enhance your winter paintings. So let's start off with the very first brush called Fog. The way I like to work with these brushes, I can certainly build a snow scene from any of these brushes, but I also like to use them to enhance paintings that I've already done. So what I like to do is add a new layer directly above my painting, and in Painter Essentials 7, you can now lock the canvas layer so you're not tempted to paint on it. So I'm going ahead and adding a new layer here, and I'm going to start building this layer up using the brush called Fog. The approach I take here is creating maybe the effect of some atmospheric conditions such as fog in this area. Now, a lot of times when I'm working with Painter Essentials, these brushes, and many of them, are based upon what we call particle brushes. And so we can use them to a certain degree, but it's also good to be able to add different brushes to the effect to enhance it even further. So one of the things I would do if I was going to create this look of fog over the background of this painting, or the middle ground of this painting, is that I would work with the opacity slider to bring the slider down slightly so the effect is a little bit softer. And I'm still getting kind of the look I'm after, but the effect is just a little softer and muted. I can also work with blenders, and in Painter Essentials, they have some wonderful blender brushes, and one of my favorite is the coarse smear blender. And I could use that perhaps along some of the edges just to soften the effect even further. And the size of the brush can be controlled with a shortcut called Control-Alt or Command-Alt to increase or decrease the size of the brush. And now I've created kind of this look of fog that enhances that feeling of depth into the background of the painting, or to the middle ground of the painting. The next brush we're going to look at is called Frosty. And I'm going to reset this brush to default, and I can do that by selecting the Reset tool, and that will restore it to the default settings. Now I'm going to sample some of the color that I see over on this side of the painting by holding down the Alt key, which is the shortcut, and I can start experimenting with the brush. And you'll notice that this brush creates a nice textural effect. So if I was looking to add texture over a certain part of the painting, and what I'm going to do here is delete this layer now and start over so you can see this a little more clearly, and go ahead and put that frosty brush over this area too. And again, that's kind of creating an atmospheric condition. I always tend to work with the opacity slider and bring the opacity slider down if I feel the effect is a little too strong. So these are all one of the reasons why, some of the many reasons why it's good to work on layers, because it gives you that flexibility to be able to control things a little bit better. There's also the option of working with what we call composite methods, which we can also change and experiment with. So if I wanted to change the effect of this, I could change the layer to overlay, and you can see how I create this nice, beautiful glow across the painting. And then I can also bring that effect down by using the opacity slider. And I get that beautiful glow going on in that area. That might be exactly what you need. Let's go ahead and add a new layer now, and the next brush we'll look at is called Frozen. This brush I usually will use to create the look of ice on a little lake or river. along the edges. You can see how I'm applying it here. So it's a nice brush for creating texture. Sometimes in these mounds of snow, you'll have little areas with highlights where the sun is just catching the tops. And this is another good brush to use to create that effect. And that's frozen. The next brush is called Ice Crystals. And this is one of my favorite brushes for creating the look of icicles on trees and buildings. I will tend to use more of a blue color here, and I'm going to go ahead and get kind of a mid-saturated blue, and I'm going to come over to my trees, and let's go ahead and add another layer here so I can show you this on a layer. And I'm just going to start dabbing in these look of icicles. And if you keep pressure, firm pressure on the brush stroke, the brush icicle is going, the stroke is going to become more saturated and more pronounced in color. So if you were looking for something a little stronger, then this would be just keep pressure on that brush as you lay down the stroke. And if you just want a quick stroke, then just go ahead and dab it throughout the area that you want to impart the icicles. You can also work with a flowing motion, such as this. If I went directly along this edge of the tree and simply filled it in with ice crystals. So that's the brush called Ice Crystal. The next brush is Large Snowflake, and we'll do this one on a layer as well. And this one, you'll want to choose a white color for your snow and just go ahead and let those ice crystals or those snowflakes fly. And the best approach for this one is to put firm pressure on the stroke when you're applying it. So you get more of a dotty effect that has a lot of spacing in between it, similar to what you'd see in a regular snowfall. So firm pressure and apply it that way. Then I'm gonna go ahead and go back down to another brush stroke or another brush category here called Small Flake. I would add a layer to that as well. And this is a smaller stroke, a smaller snowflake, but you can see that it really adds to the effect of snow falling. And then of course, remember, you can always bring down the opacity to minimize the effect on that layer and give a much softer snowfall effect. The next brush is called Powder, and this brush I would use to build up areas of snow. So if I was looking for more of a fluffy kind of snowfall in certain areas here, you can see how beautiful that brush is. And that one is called Powder. The next brush is Settled. Not only is this brush good for creating the look of settled snow on the ground, but it's also nice for those heavier settled areas of snow on trees. So I'm going to sample this color here, and this is how I would use it to just kind of fill in areas of heavy snow on settling on the branches of trees. So this would be a way that you could work with this brush. It's more of a detailed brush, and I'll show you how you can use it for details as well. then I can always use a blender again to softly blend that effect. So if I need those edges to be a little softer, that would be how I would approach that. I also use it for, in a very small brush size, to create tree trunks. So it's a nice brush for creating little trunks of trees and stems and anywhere where you might need the look of little branches and trees coming out. The next brush is called Sleet, and I'm going to close a few layers here so I can show this one to you. And again, you'd use a lighter color, and the approach that you would take with this is just long, sweeping brush strokes across and up and down to create the effect of heavy snow or sleet falling. I showed you the small flake, and the last brush is called Snow Globe. And again, this brush is kind of more of an effects brush where you might just want to add. I was thinking it would be interesting to maybe show the look of blowing snow, you know, coming through. So these would be long, sweeping brush strokes. And I think that that's very effective in showing that kind of stormy look and snow blowing in the wind. The effect can be minimized again by bringing the opacity slider down if you don't want it to be, you know, quite as heavy. So I hope you'll enjoy this beautiful brush pack called Snow for Painter Essentials. Take care.